everybody, and welcome back to another video. Today we are doing a collaboration with Luis. I'm not sure how to say your channel name.
Luis is Spilled Animations. Right. LOL.
So we're doing a collaboration with Luis Spilled Animations. And this is all a little bit new, so we'll hope it works out. We are back doing another episode of Taiga Clan. Are you excited?
Yeah, I am. Nice. This is one of my first collaborations, so...
Hey, it is for me too. First time for everything, I suppose.
Yeah.
So, starting off in the clan, Lotus Dart tossed a snake out of camp before it could bite someone. That's good. Log Cone has recovered from Yellow Cough. Almond Hair is seen racing around the border with... Racing along the border with a rival from Snake Clan. Kite Call no longer has a running nose. Kite Call was...
That's good.
Yeah, that's always good. Kite Call was lording around Snake Clan's border looking for a specific cat. I wonder who that could be.
Ooh.
We'll have to check that out. So, I wonder what their history is. So they were born inside the clan. Oh, they're half clan. Maybe it's a parent from another clan. Who knows? Maybe a lover? Who knows?
Yeah.
Bloomfur confesses their feelings to Flaxgrove but gets rejected. Uh-oh. So
That is really sad.
Yeah, that is actually pretty disappointing for them. I'm not quite sure why they got rejected. Maybe they just don't have a good relationship. Let's see, where are they?
Not really that good at voiceovers because, yeah.
Yeah, that's reasonable. I'm not very good at it either, so I just kind of play along as it goes along. So they have.
I'm not used to it. I normally animate, so yeah.
Yeah, I'm usually animating too. I rarely do voice acting or voiceovers. I typically have a script, so I can kind of read what's on the screen. So they have a very small dislike for Bloomfur, which is reasonable, I guess. You just rejected them. Let's see, where are we? Fermain's seen talking calmly to a loner. Both cats went their separate ways. Taiga Clan welcomes Dusty Fur, a new warner honoring their dependability.
So looks ooh. Like,
so I like that name, Dusty Fluff.
New warriors are always welcome.
Yeah. And Quickstar rests their muzzles on Pine Bubble's head, declares them a full warrior of Taiga Clan, honoring their skill. Oh, they're really pretty. I like them.
Yeah.
How about we
I
do
just
some...
wanted to say that.
Yeah. How about we do some patrols? Should we start with the medicine cats?
Yeah, because they have to find herbs and stuff. Yeah. So, yeah.
Let's send Grouse, I think that's how you say it. Grouse Shade, Lilac Freckle, Cone Tail. One of my friends asked me to name a character Luke Skywalker.
From Star Wars.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. I don't usually watch that. That's one of my parents' their things, so yeah, I don't really know.
Yeah.
Isn't that like the son of Darth Vader or something?
Yes, it is. You know more than I did without even watching it.
Oh, wow.
Should we send a warrior with them, or do you think just the three medicine cats is good enough?
I think that'll do.
Mm-hmm. So we're going on patrol. The patrol finds a nice spot to sun themselves. I say we proceed on that.
Yeah, well, like that's kind of, yeah.
Little cat things. The sunlight feels great and the cats have a successful discussion talking about what came up at the last Half Moon meeting and whether it'll affect the clan. Catmint was gathered. That's good.
I was trying to find a word, but I couldn't find it, so I was stuttering.
Oh no, that's all good. Hey, I don't do good on camera without a script either, so I stutter a lot.
Okay.
Well.
Yeah, my only few voice over videos were, like, back when I started my YouTube channel and, like, the last video of mine, so, yeah.
Yeah, so you have a clan as well now. You have Bliss Clan, correct?
Yeah, I do.
And, is it also in Clan Gen?
Yeah, it's also on Clan Gen, but I'm playing it on my iPad. What means I'm not really going to play the game unless you want me to, but
that's yeah. I like what you did last episode where you drew the characters. I definitely like Cod Willow. They're probably my favorite.
Yeah, my favorite is Sage Star. I like her name and she's pretty. So thank you. I love what's his name or her? Sorry. The one I drew for you, Jesus.
What was her name? Patchfin, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. She does Patch kind of look like Duchess from the Aristocats.
Yeah, I guess.
Should we send some more warriors out on another patrol?
I would send the deputy out and some other cats.
Yeah. How about we do 3 random cats to go with?
Nice. Yeah.
So, randomly picked Hazelberry, Gentle Leaf, and Logcomb.
That seems awesome.
Mm-hmm. So the patrol is checking the borderlines. They hear some sound of paw steps through the territory. Should they proceed or do not proceed?
I would, in my opinion, I would try something new and antagonize. Let's see what that.
The patrol tends to find an intruder, kitty pet. No wonder they were so loud. It's to scare them off easily.
Oof. Yeah.
The kitty pet, get out of here. How about we send some more warriors out?
Yeah, I mean, like, if I were them, if I were Taiga Clan, I think that's how you say it. I'm not pretty sure. If I were them, I would probably just run away, but okay.
Yeah, that's reasonable. Then again, it was 3 fully trained warriors versus a little kitty pet.
Yeah, but you couldn't know if you wouldn't have checked, so yeah.
Yeah, so we're doing another one. We have Buckwhisker, Kite Call, Scorch Tough, Stream Dapple, Patchfin.
My favorite Patchfin!
Patchfin! And Dusty Fluff. I like that name. So,
yeah, that's a really cute name. That sounds like a kitty pet would call themselves.
I think
like
they were
that.
Actually originally a kitty pet because they have the collar.
Oh, that matches perfectly, actually.
Yeah. So, the patrol notices a commotion and finds 2 squirrels chasing each other across the forest floor. I think if we proceed, it would be some easy fresh skill.
Mm-hmm. Wait, didn't you have a character in Taiga Clan named Mabel or something?
Yeah, I did. So Scorchtuff tries to climb a tree after them, but slips and falls, twisting their paw. Uh-oh. They fell.
Ouch.
Yeah, this is Mabel.
Yeah, I find that name quite funny because I have a kitten now named Maple, like Maple Shade. Yeah, we named her after Maple Shade, actually, because she kind of looks like her.
Ooh, I actually have a tortoiseshell kitten, too, named Luna.
Oh, that's such a cute name. I like that. So, we also have another kitten named Gonzo.
Oh, I like that name. It's really unique.
Yeah.
So we are sending Mabel, Luke. I'm just going to call him Luke, it's easier. Luke.
Yeah.
Pheasant Whistle, Might Heather, Flax Grove, and Quiversack. Should we do like a border, hunting, or training?
I would do a hunting patrol because I don't think we'll have enough food otherwise.
Yeah. So the patrol sees the shadow of a school of fish in the river. I think if we proceed, we could try and catch the fish.
Yeah, that's good.
The patrol moves too suddenly, flickering the shadow causes the fish to vanish under the murky waters.
Ah. Oh my god.
You win some, you lose some.
I guess.
So we're sending.
But they could have tried harder.
Yeah, reasonable. Sending Almond Hair, Boar Kick, Fringe Frond, Panther Shadow, Quick Star, and Bramble Shade.
Almond Hair is actually pretty cute. I like her. Or him. I'm not.
This one?
No, my god. Yeah, also, but, oh my god, why do I forget those names so quickly?
So, there's Almond Hair,
Yeah, almond hair.
Oh, let's see.
She looks like Ivy Pool.
Oh, yeah, it does look like Ivy Pool. So it's a nun, so they just go there. So we're sending Vorkick. I asked to resend again. Vorkick, Woodtail, Quickstar, Almond Hair, Botfoot, and Bramble Shade. I think since they failed both hunting patrols, we should probably try again.
Yeah.
The patrol looks around for something to disguise their scent while hunting. A stinky bush will do it. The plan works and their hunt goes well, so they got some food.
Okay, lucky for them, because otherwise they wouldn't have any food.
Yeah, they just caught like one piece of food for all these cats.
Yeah. Oh my god, oh my god.
The allegiances look really long.
You have many cats in your clan.
I do. We also found...
I only have 7 or something like that.
Then again, I have been doing this for... this one clan has been going for 61 moons.
Jesus. Also, when I make a new clan, I always just skip moons to see what happens.
Yeah,
just because it's fun.
At the very beginning, there's not much going on until you get some more cats and it finally picks up the pace.
Yeah, I'm also always searching for pretty cats to draw.
Kind of like this one, Furmane?
Yeah. That's such a cool pattern.
I think she's one of our only 2 tortoiseshell cats in this clan.
Yeah.
But I really like her. So, should we go on another hunting patrol or border?
I mean, we don't really have that much food, so I guess hunting patrol.
Let's do that. A legend has been cited. Recently, warriors report a strange mass of rats stuck together by their tails, larger and more dangerous than anything the clan has seen.
Will Lord
Stark's patrol look for this legendary monster?
I would not proceed. I mean,
no.
If you want cats to die, I guess.
Yeah, especially with such a pretty batch of cats.
Yeah.
Such a thing can exist, right? It has to be an elder's imagination. Lotus Dart decides to take the patrol elsewhere to hunt.
That's smart.
So we're sending Doefoot, French Frond, Swallowtail, Pine Bubble, I like that name, Pigeon Branch, and Drift Frond out on... What should we do? Border training or hunting?
I mean, we don't really have any apprentices, so I don't think we can do training. So I guess border patrol?
Yeah, that probably sounds like a good idea. The patrol stumbles across a long, large dog wandering across...
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Yeah. So they may be able to take along because there's 6 chained cats. We don't know.
Yeah, but... Yeah, I mean, we don't want it to go, like, into the wild. I mean, into the...
Yeah,
Jesus Christ.
Like the Swift Paw and Bright Paw situation.
Yeah, or, like when Fireheart let the dogs away from their clan. No.
The patrol decides not to pursue such a dangerous creature. Tiny clan will just have to hold near the clan. Let's time skip another minute since we finished all the patrols for this one.
Okay.
Really, one thing. Vorkick can't run as long as quickly as they did before, but they're glad their leg is healed at all. So they have a permanent condition for a weak leg. And that's the only thing that happens this week. That's actually pretty surprising.
Yeah, but I just wanted to talk about some warrior cats' deaths. I find really sad and stuff. First of all, Swiftpaw, I loved him. He was my boy. He was my boy. Yeah, from Stranger Things, Joyce.
I always felt really bad for what happened to Swiftpaw. I was actually saying this the other day on the Lion King videos last year, that I want more, like, Swiftpaw live things.
Yeah, but, like, Swiftpaw has such a cool character, and... the errands let it go to waste. Why? Why?
Like, not Bramble Frog, like, before Bramble Frog, people really make something like
Yeah. I didn't really read him yet, but I've heard about him. And that he got ran over by a monster.
Yeah.
Yeah, also another death, which most of you probably won't find that sad, but I really liked Ashfur.
I liked him too.
Like, everyone loves Hollyleaf and stuff, but I find her a bit, like,
a little bit too.
Not to be mean, but she finds herself amazing.
A little bit,
in my opinion. Yeah.
I think Ash for being a little bit too possessive over Squirrelflight was a wrong thing. I think Hollyleaf immediately jumping to the conclusion she had to kill him was a little bit much.
Yeah. Ash for just wanted to have a mate, so yeah.
But even though like the whole like Hollyleaf going and like still going to the clan, like the big meeting thing and saying it anyways, if Ash would have done that, I feel like it just would have gone the same, except Hollyleaf wouldn't have gotten trapped in Toad. It may have even gone better, because Hollyleaf would have stayed in the clan.
Yeah. I mean, I'm just saying yeah and stuff, but I haven't read that yet, to be honest.
Basically, Hollyleaf told the whole clan after she killed Ashfur. She didn't. I don't think she told them that she killed Ashfur, but she told them that Squirrelflight's not my mom, blah 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 blah. Even though that's exactly what Ashfur was gonna do, and she didn't want him to say that.
I find that pretty rude of Squirrelflight that she just yelled at Ashfur that they weren't her kids.
She probably could have handled the situation a lot better.
Right in front of her ex-kids, I guess ex-kids. Yeah, all that stuff. I'm not really good at English, sorry.
Oh no, you're all good. I understand what you're saying.
I hope the fans do too, because otherwise I'm effed up.
Yeah, I'm sure they'll understand.
I hope that the audio doesn't corrupt or something.
I think it should be good because like my little desktop monitor thing, so that's all working out.
Yeah, okay.
So we're sending Quiversap, Doughfoot, Dusty Fluff, Habika, I don't even know how to say her name. Habika, I think.
Habika, yeah.
Habika.
In my language, I would say like Habika, but yeah.
Okay. Yours makes
me I like Habika more, to be honest.
Mm-hmm. Gentle Leaf and Luke are probably, let's go on a border patrol, how's that sound?
Okay. That's good for me, it's your clan, I mean. Mm-hmm. Another large dog, or is it the same one?
So, though I think that it may be dangerous, I think they could potentially take in the dog, because there's six of them.
I guess so, but how many former kitty pets are in the patrol?
From what it looks like, maybe two, because I see two collars, but then again, that may just
be... Yeah.
They got abducted by a two leg for a few days. I'm thinking Doughfoot was a kitty pet and Gentle Leaf just got it randomly.
Yeah, proceed, I guess.
No one died.
Let's see.
Habika has just enough time to yell out a plan, leading the whole large patrol to a skillful battle plan against a dog that protects the cats from any chance of injury. The dog tucks the tail and runs to more friendly land, so they handle it pretty well.
Okay. Good job, Habika.
Yeah, Habika's a smart cat. Let's check real quick. So Doughfoot was formerly a kitty pet, and Gentle Leaf just randomly got a collar.
Time is it for you, actually?
It is currently 3 p.m. where I live.
Oh, that's why you have so much time.
Yeah. Either that or just, yeah. Time differences is always a big deal.
Don't you have school? Just asking.
Oh, I do homeschool, so we have a different schedule than other schools.
Oh, cool.
So
I'm always wondering what it's like to be homeschooled.
It's certainly different. One slightly disappointing aspect is a lot of my friends are public school, and when they're talking about it, I don't really get to be involved in the conversation because I don't know what to say.
Yeah.
So I just like silently listening. So, Pheasant Whistle, Spies, Fat Rabbit, On the Other Side, Sleepy Clan Border, A Tempting Opportunity to Be Sure, But It May Not Be Wise to Hunt Different Clans Territory.
This kind of reminds me of Shroopaw.
Yeah.
But then with borders.
So, I don't think it's a good idea because the reputation with Sleepy Clan may worsen.
Yeah, and always when cats go over the border, there are always cats looking for some reason, and they can always see them. I don't understand how they can be everywhere. Blah, 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 blah.
Yeah, it never ends out well, so we should probably just do
that. Yeah. Yeah.
So the patrols decide that one cat isn't worth making. No, that one rabbit isn't worth making.
My laugh is so weird. Sorry.
No, it's okay. I like it. I think it's cute. Anyways, S Patrol spreads out the hunt. Stream Dapple admits that they had a vision from StarClan last night.
Yeah, proceed.
Stream Dapple notices Buckwall looking enviously with y'all from the rest of the patrol. This is the dream is unimportant. So, Buckroar's jealous of him.
Also, I've seen one of your Clan Gen videos, and I think it was your last one. You said you want someone to draw, like, one of the cats throwing a snowball at one of the kittens.
I think it was something like Mabel and maybe Gentleleaf, maybe, were having a snowball fight.
Yeah. If you want me, I can draw that.
Sure, I'll make a community post for the exact characters. But thank you.
No problem, I like drawing.
I was like, thank you. So, it's Greenleaf now, which is summer.
Mm-hmm.
So Lilac Freckle disappears for a few days, then returns to camp with a blue nylon collar around the neck. Oh, that actually their eyes pretty well.
Yeah, pretty colors.
Pigeon Branch has gotten a heat stroke.
Oops.
Patch Finn has gotten fleas.
No.
No.
I'm going to die if she dies.
I don't think the fleas will really hurt them that much. They can still work, so it can't be that bad.
Yeah, but I mean, like, if she gets murdered, I'm going to cry.
I probably will as well, because I've gotten really attached to the character now.
Yeah.
Botfoot was cut short. Sharing prey with a rogue who was chased off by the patrol. Almond Hair confesses their feelings to Drift from, but they got rejected. So many getting rejected.
Why does everyone get rejected here? Oh my god.
That's what I was thinking. Everyone keeps on getting rejected by everyone else. So, I never really saw that together. Anyways. Flax Grove has gotten fleas. Scorch Tuft can walk without pain. Their sprain must have healed. The Tansy went bad. So, let's send some medicine cats. I always start out with medicine cats, then do random sporadic cats to go along with it.
Okay, that's good.
Mm-hmm. So, we're doing the medicine cats. Gorse, I don't know how to say it. Gorse Shade, Lilac Freckle, and Conetail, with Dusty Fluff, Swallowtail, and Almond Hair.
Yeah.
Gorse has protection territory with their entourage. They feel a presence join them. Since familiar pelt reaches Swallowtail's nose, they know this cat. With a friendly purr, they turn and greet their friend from beyond the grave. The rest of the patrol gives them some space. Mallow and Raspberry will gather.
That's awesome!
Yeah! Swallowtail got to see dead friend again. I wonder what that could have been out of all the cats.
Many cats have died with you also.
Yeah, I think it's exactly one page because you always start off with one cat here.
Yeah.
Then it's just Baba Yaga for here.
we should really do another hunting patrol. Because, yeah.
The patrol comes across a strange two-leg object smelling slightly of smoke and prey. Intriguing, but also sort of terrifying. Both two legs are in danger. Fine. Should we proceed?
I wouldn't, but that's up to you.
Some tells me it's probably something to do with cigarettes, because...
Yeah.
Smoking, fire. Patrol decides to avoid the two-leg. So, they got no hunting done, so we should probably try again for hunting.
Yeah.
Ooh, the patrol hears a distant howling and wonders whether to investigate the noise. Now, typically when I
wolf?
Think it's like a kitty kind of like that getting chased by a dog, I think it's worth a shot at least seeing.
Oh. I would proceed just for fun,
and
I guess. And we can save the kitty pet if that is. So. What?
They check the noise of coyote before the patrol can investigate further. Lotus start looking tear at the sight of the beast and dash in the way. The patrol follows, interesting, not wanting to lose sight of their plan might well commit wild coyotes.
Will I sound dumb if I say I didn't know there were wild coyotes? Or.
No, that makes sense, actually. I mean, where I live, I don't think there's any coyotes.
Yeah, I don't think so with me, so... Jesus, I can't not talk.
It's okay. So, Lotus Dart was a little chicken and ran off, so the rest of the patrol had to follow them. So, again, there was no hunting. Should we try again for hunting?
Yeah. Let's try until we catch something.
The patrol notices a commotion and finds two squirrels chasing each other across the forest floor.
If we proceed, we have both squirrels, maybe, so,
Buckroar is quick on the jump, so the squirrels notice the cats begin scampering away. Buckroar easily cuts them off and kills both the squirrels, so we have two squirrels now.
Awesome.
Now that we got some hunting done, maybe we should check with the border to make sure the other clans aren't angry at us.
Yeah, I mean, why would they? We just rejected it when one of the cats wanted to go across the border, so they can't be mad at us.
Ooh, this sounds interesting. The patrol is checking alongside the borderline, but they hear a small sound and a hint of pain. They quickly follow the source. It's a loner, and they appear to be injured.
Proceed, I would help them.
Yeah. Mage Flight join the clan. That doesn't matter right there. Mage Flight, let's find them.
Oh, I see him, yeah. They're,
Oh, there they are!
Down, yeah.
Oh, they're so young. They're literally 16 moons old. They have...
But they all look so old when they lay in that position. They look like elders.
They do, kinda. Maybe because our only elder is also in that position.
Yeah, we only have one elder? What?
I don't know how. Like, we have one elder here and then it goes to that. When we go up here, it says there's only one elder.
We have so many warriors. What the?
Yeah. Well, I guess technically they count as an elder. I don't know why they haven't retired yet.
I guess they just want to help the warriors and stuff.
That makes sense. So, we'll probably have two elders here soon. So, Mage Flight only has a mangled leg, which probably will heal unless it gets infected.
Mm-hmm.
So, sure, the medicine cats will keep an eye on them. We can go on one more patrol. Looks like President Whistle won't be going today because it's just one cat. She'll send Buck Whisker, Warkick, Patchfin the baby, Noobie,
yeah.
Scream Dapple, Botfoot, and Flex Grove. Should be
some. Wow, Flex Grove is injured a lot.
Oh, they are?
I don't know if that's a pattern or wounds.
Well, I think that's their fur pattern, I think.
Oh.
You're not wrong, though, because it looks like that right there is a scar at the base of
the. Yeah.
So, should we do border again, or should we do more hunting?
hunting. We still don't have enough, I think.
Yeah. It's the rat thing again. It's the exact same one. This is like the third time we've gotten the same rat text.
Proceed this time?
The Rat King Lair is defended heavily by smaller rats. Control doesn't find any side of the Rat King. They manage to need to bring back a feast of small rats.
I guess that's food?
Yeah, I think rats count. So that's not a bad thing, I guess. Oh my goodness, more confessions. Nightingale Bat confesses their feelings to Doefoot. And they've become mates.
Finally, someone who becomes mates.
Yeah, so Doefoot and Nightingale Bat. Yeah, they work pretty good together. Yeah, I like that. Pigeon Branch has recovered from her heat stroke. Buckwhisker tries to convince Habitha to run away with them.
Why?
I have no clue. I think they failed. Boar-Pig Pokemon splitting
headache. Aren't Buckwhisker and Habitha related, or?
I don't think they're canonically related. He has a mate.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh. Is this like another Squirrel Fight and Brando Star and Jesse situation?
I think.
Uh-oh. Oh, Lilac Freck was just jealously watching, like, Boar-Kick, I keep saying it wrong. Boar-Kick woke up with a splitting headache they couldn't get out of the nest. They spent the entire day curled up trying to avoid light and noise so that throbbing pain could subside. Fringe Frond was speaking calmly to a cat from the Low Clan. Vermane confesses their feelings to Logcomb but got rejected. Everyone keeps getting rejected.
Oh my god!
You'd think we're getting even closer in real life to Valentine's Day. Less cats would be getting rejected, but apparently not.
Yeah.
So finally, Luke Skywalker is now an elder.
Finally, that took some time.
Mm-hmm. I think he's like 2 moons late to becoming an elder, because I think once you reach 130, you become an elder, but holy moly, Horizon's almost at like 300 moons.
Yeah, I've seen a cat with like 332 moons old, and I was like, that's the most I've seen ever.
That's kind of crazy.
In my life.
So, let's send some more random cats, like medicine cats out on patrol. We can send, Lilac Freckle, let's send your mate with you. He's been acting a little bit weird with some other cats.
Sometimes I just send two out together so that they can,
Ooh.
Yeah.
Do we want to do that?
Spend some time together.
Is there anyone you ship together? If you want, we can do that.
Let's do, Batchfin with someone, I guess?
Let's see who they're closest with in their relationships. Look like... They don't have much romantic-like for anyone other than Buckwhisker, who already has a mate. Uh-oh. Oh, they're like Logcomb.
Oh, yeah.
So they like Logcomb. Let's see. Logcomb does not have a mate.
You know, they could be a gay couple, I guess.
Oh, yeah, they could. Do you want to do that?
Yeah.
All right, let's do that.
They couldn't get any kids, but...
that doesn't matter. Ta-da! That's great.
Yay!
So let's send them out together. Should we do patrol or border or hunting or training? I think if we do training. Okay, so we're going to send them on a patrol?
Mm-hmm, that's good.
So, Patchfin suggests this might be a good chance to practice new hunting techniques with Logcomb. I say we
can. That's good.
Both practice sets and swapping their best tips and tricks with each other. That's sweet.
Yeah. They will be a good couple.
They will.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, So I'm kind of confused what mediators are supposed to do.
Basically, like, if the clan has troubles with another clan, they are there to just kind of, like, settle the argument and kind of get the cat.
Yeah, then we definitely need that.
Do we see anyone who may be a mediator? Maybe if we get another kitty cat in there, they might be a mediator.
Yeah, but, like, in the few videos I've seen of Tiger Clan, I've had my eyes not only on Finpatch. Oh my god, sorry, no, Patch was.
You're good.
But also on Logcone. He seems like. She seems like a good mediator. Oh yeah, they're a couple now.
Actually, not.
Oh no! Tulak traps.
Oh yeah, so I saw that, so I was like, nope.
You just immediately clicked on Do Not Proceed.
We do not want any cats getting abducted. Chol heads out into the forest to hunt. Almanhair suggests a good sheltered gully. It's a little far from camp, but hunting around there is good, particularly for mice.
Okay.
Almanhair suggests that the hunting grounds did not work. Not that anyone blames them for it. It's fine. They just suggested it just did not work. The troll pokes a two-leg nest while hunting. A two-leg nest is basically someone's house.
Mm-hmm.
I don't see anyone of major importance down here, so I think we're good to explore it.
Yeah. I mean, only the ones we really like will keep them out of this.
Two like kits stomp through the woods, scaring away prey and ruining the hunt. But no one got hurt though.
Aw, stupid two like kits.
Stupid, probably me. I just go out there and just scare away all the prey. Oh.
Okay.
As the trolls okay. Okay.
Yeah, or another injured loner.
Dusty Fluff drops down to a hunting crouch, certain that a mouse must be the source of noise. They find themselves wrecked and a pounce. And the first returning troll with a tasty morsel dangling from the mouth. So yeah, it was a mouse.
Okay.
Maybe we could, since we've already been recording for a long time, we can do a few more moons, and it won't be a full episode, but I think it'd be pretty good.
Yeah.
So, Patch Finn has finally gotten rid of their fleas. That's good. Borkick breathes a small sigh of relief, finally the deep dropping their heads subsides. Panther Shadow has gotten a stomachache. I don't remember that name. Oh, no, I do remember them. Flaxgrove's gotten rid of their fleas at last. Pine Bubble is seen arguing and borderline fighting with a little dog.
Oh no.
Oh well, they'll probably be fine. It's famous last
words. Yeah, but maybe they're in a toxic relationship.
Maybe. Should we keep. I'm gonna write that down real quick. Give me just a second.
Someone should make an animation, a sort of funny animation meme. With one of your characters, if they fit the vibe, like, Mom, am I adopted? Yeah.
Yes.
Oh.
Oh. I feel like I should do that for another character. I think I have a few characters in mind that would work for.
Which ones?
There was a character from, like, a little short thing that I wrote named Snake Fang, and I'm pretty sure she found a kit named Wolf Kit or something like that.
That's cute. I want to make that now.
Yeah. maybe we collaborate on it?
Yeah, that sounds good. I like collaborating.
Yeah. I'll
Even though I'm not that good at collaborations, I never finish my own part. I sometimes do, but I don't have much motivation.
I mean, hey, that's reasonable. I get like, so you've heard the term art block before, right?
Yeah, I have that all the time.
Yeah, me too. That's why I haven't made a ton of art. I've been making more thumbnails recently.
Yeah, I noticed. I have seen some of your videos.
Yeah. Mostly because I like drawing more than full-blown animations. Or preferably making them. Obviously, I love watching animations. Yes, making them is... It takes a lot of work, and I respect all the animators out there.
Yeah, but like, I love animating and stuff, but like, the time that goes into it, I'm not such a fan of it.
Yeah, it always takes a long time to make certain animations. Plus, sometimes when I just get an idea, I just get done real quick.
I always make a sketch, and I try to make myself do it, and I'm begging myself to finish it and stuff, but I never do.
And then our brain conveniently comes up with something else that we have to do right that second.
Yeah. And that makes me stressed. That's why lately I am not making animation memes.
And
also, I do not have any inspiration. I can't find any sound.
So quick, but I finished it.
Did you like it?
Yeah, I would say it was decent. It was really kind of, I wouldn't say rushed, but not the best skill level, but I'd say it looked pretty good.
I want to see that.
I'll send you the link to the video. I can't remember what it was called, but I'll send you the link to the video after this.
Okay, that's good.
We have been recording for a long time, and I think this has been a pretty good episode. What do you say?
I say that too. Although I am really bad at talking right now for some reason, so yeah.
That's reasonable. I think it's about time we wrap up the episode. What do you say?
Yeah.
Well, I hope you all enjoyed the video. I will link Luis's channel in the description. I've had a really good time today. I will see y'all next episode. Goodbye.
Bye.